Hello friends. Welcome to Tech Talks Engineered channel. Today we will discuss about one of the most important topics of electrical substation. We will discuss about different bus bar schemes and used in electrical substation. Guys, for convenience purpose, this video is split into two parts. This is part one. First, let's see, what is bus bar? In simple words, bus bar is common connection point, or a node for multiple incoming and outgoing circuits such as power lines or feeders. As we know, it is impractical to connect multiple conductors at one point. Hence we use bus bars, where these connections can be done spaciously and conveniently. So let's start with different bus bar schemes or systems in electrical substation. 1. Single bus system. This is the most basic and simple bus bar system, as we can see in the diagram. In this type, all incoming and outgoing bays such as lines, transformers, feeders are directly connected to single bus. Advantages of the system are as follows. Due to its simple design, it is most easy and convenient for operation. Also, it is very economical, because of its least capital cost among all bus bar systems. Now, disadvantages. In this type, maintenance activity of any bay or equipment such as transformer is not possible without service interruption of the particular bay or equipment. Also, in case of fault on bus or bus maintenance, all the bays connected to bus get interrupted. 2. Single bus sectionalized system. This is single bus system, with additional circuit breaker and isolators, making two different sections of bus, hence called as single bus sectionalized system. What are advantages of single bus sectionalized system? Since there are two sections, separated by circuit breaker, fault on one section does not interrupt other section of the bus. Circuit breaker isolates faulty section from healthy one. Also, maintenance of bus section can be done individually, without affecting other section. Hence, power supply continuity is maintained. Now, disadvantages. Cost of circuit breaker and isolators is added to capital cost. 3. Main and transfer bus system. As shown in diagram, there are two buses, one main bus and other transfer bus, also called as auxiliary bus. Each bay or equipment such as line, transformer are connected to both the buses, to main bus through circuit breaker and isolators, and to transfer bus through auxiliary isolator only. These two buses are connected by circuit breaker and isolators, called as bus coupler, and this bay is called transfer bus coupler TBC bay. In normal condition, load of all bays is on main bus, and transfer bus is in standby mode, that means auxiliary isolators are open. Also, TBC bay circuit breaker and isolators are open, so this is normal condition. Because of such arrangement, load of any bay can be shifted on transfer bus. Now for example, let's see how load of transformer 1 is shifted on transfer bus. First, auxiliary isolator of transformer 1 is closed, both isolators of TBC bay are closed, TBC breaker is charged, main circuit breaker of transformer 1 is opened, and then bus and line isolators of transformer 1 are opened. Hence, load of transformer 1 is shifted on transfer bus. To take load back on main bus, exactly reverse procedure is followed. Close bus and line isolators of transformer 1, close circuit breaker of transformer 1, open TBC circuit breaker along with both TBC isolators, and then finally open auxiliary isolator of the transformer 1. For complete TBC operation, please click on the link given. In case of fault on main bus, all bays connected to bus get interrupted. Now let's see advantages of having main and transformer bus bar system. Circuit breaker maintenance of any bay can be done without interrupting power supply. This arrangement provides more flexibility. Let's see what disadvantages of the system are. Only disadvantage is that it adds up the cost of auxiliary bus, TBC breaker and isolators. 4. Double breaker bus system. As name says, there are two bus bars, bus 1 and bus 2, we can see in the diagram, and each bay or equipment such as line, transformer is connected to both the buses, through breaker and isolators to each bus. Means each bay has two breakers for bus 1 and bus 2, hence this is called as double breaker bus system. Difference between this one and previous transfer bus system is that, in this system each bay has two breaker, whereas in case of transfer bus system, each bay has only one breaker and auxiliary isolator. Hence this system does not require separate TBC bay. In normal condition, Both the buses are charged. Here bus 1 is charged with line 1, and bus 2 is charged with line 2. Half of the bays are loaded on one bus and remaining half on other bus. Here in the diagram, we can see transformer 1 is loaded on bus 1 by closing bus 1 side breaker and isolators. Similarly, transformer 2 is loaded on bus 2 by closing bus 2 side breaker and isolators. Hence only respective breakers and isolators are closed of the particular bay, others are kept open. This is normal condition. Now let's see how to shift load of transformer 1 from bus 1 to bus 2. First, close bus 2 side isolators, close bus 2 side circuit breaker, now open bus 1 side circuit breaker and isolators. Hence load of transformer 1 is shifted from bus 1 to bus 2 effortlessly. To shift load back bus 1, exact reverse procedure is followed. Close bus 1 side isolator and breaker, then open bus 2 side breaker and isolators. Now consider fault conditions. In case of fault on bus 1, complete load can be shifted on bus 2. And in case of fault on bus 2, complete load can be shifted on bus 1. Hence there is minimum interruption in case of bus faults. Now let's look at advantages of double breaker bus system. This system is most flexible and causes least interruption. Disadvantages. Capital cost is very high as 2 breakers are required for each bay. 5. Double breaker bus system with bus sectionalized. As name says, this is nothing but double breaker bus system with one bus sectionalized. Advantages. Due to sectionalized bus, flexibility and reliability of system increases. Disadvantages. This sectionalized bus increases cost and maintenance of the system. So these are some of the bus bar systems used in electrical substation. Remaining bus bar systems are discussed in part 2 of this video. For part 2, please click on the link. Hope you liked the video. If yes, please hit the like button. For more videos, please subscribe. Thank you.